Yo, it is good. Yo, it's your boy Ty back here with another video. And in this video today, we are going to be talking about how to get scary Terry quickly in NBA 2K22, my team. So, gonna be in this video if you obviously are watching this, you're probably interested in Terry Rozier. We're gonna cover his stats badges later on in this video, but first, we're just gonna be talking about how long does it take to get through all of these challenges and what is the best way to go about it? Now, before we dive into that, if you are new to my channel and have not yet, please consider smashing that subscribe button as we're on the road to 80,000 subscribers. So the first thing you got to see are you know, what is triple threat specific? What is not going to be attainable in triple threat? All those types of things. So you're going to have to do some things in a challenge game, so you have to know that as well. So what I like to do is combo some of the triple threat stuff up. So, got to win three triple threat or triple threat offline game, triple threat online games using three Celtics players. You have to know that you have to do that right away. There's really no way to kind of combine anything with that, right? So that's probably the first thing I do is go into three triple threat offline games with three Celtics players. That's the first thing you have to do. Obviously, I don't think there's a Terry Rozier Celtics card or anything like that. So, I mean, that's out of the question. So, really, you just got to, that's where I would really honestly start is just get those three games out of the way. Because then you're going to have one already accomplished. So, just get those out of the way. Then the next thing is this, right? Making 8 3-pointers with a shooting guard in a single game. I would combine these things, okay? Here's what I would combine in general. I combine the 4 3-pointers in a challenge game, the 8 3-pointers in a with a small shooting guard in a single game, combine those two things right away. I'd also combine the double-double with a Suns player. All three of those things, you should be able to get done in one challenge game. Now, that's what I would focus on in the challenge games. Obviously, if you want to really, this is 8 3-pointers with a shooting guard in a single game. So if you want to combine that with, you know, a Pacer shooting guard, you could work on that as well. But the big thing is that you just do one challenge game. You don't want to have to go into domination, anything else to get this double-double. But get a double-double with the Suns where maybe a center DeAndre Ayton, it doesn't really matter, done in a challenge game. Combine that with, obviously, the 8 3-pointers with the shooting guard. Probably a Pacers shooting guard is what I would suggest. And then 4 3-pointers with a Pacers power forward. So that's what I would do. Pacers shooting guard, Pacers power forward. Then you can start chipping away at the 109 points with Pacers players over multiple games, okay? Then that's like the challenge side of it. We also have the triple threat side of it, what you need to do. So 14 assists with Nets players, it can be any players. It doesn't really matter. 5 blocks with Hawks players. I mean, honestly, blocks are probably easier to get in triple threat offline than anything else. Just use a Hawks center. Should have the double-doubles done. 23 rebounds with 76ers players. That's really easy to get as well. What I'll do is if you do go into a challenge type of game, just surround those other players, you know, with either these two things. Maybe Pacers players to score with them, or just 76ers players to maybe get a few extra rebounds. 28 points with Grizzlies players is easy enough to do. You can combine that with the Harden challenge or the Nets assist. Remember, what you're really going to have to do is 32 points with Hornets players. The last thing you want to have to do, and the reason I want you guys to chip away at this Pacers kind of points and make the threes with shooting guards with Pacers players, as well as the power forward threes with Pacers players, because you got to score 109 points, you got to score 32 points, and then you got to also score 28 points. So there's a lot of points that you need. And that's why I'm telling you guys, if you guys can find a way to chip away at the Pacers points in general, that will be very, very helpful. How long is this challenge, or how long is it going to take to get Scary Terry? That's probably the question of the day. My answer is going to probably be right around an hour. I think if you play the game and really maximize it, you can get it done in an hour. Just one single challenge game, a few triple threat offline games, you're going to be able to get it done. Maybe a little over an hour, because the hardest part of this challenge is you got to win 3 triple threat offline games right away using 3 Celtics players. That's probably the hardest part of this challenge in general. So you're probably going to have to spend a little over an hour, probably right around an hour. So how to get Terry Rozier in an hour if you do know those things. So the big thing, in the one challenge game, you want to focus on Terry Rozier's threes. You want to focus on this. you also do want to focus on the double-double. Those three things are really what I focus on and winning with Pacers players. So if I was you guys, I would build this type of a lineup to go into a challenge game. I'm just going to build a starting lineup for you guys. So you need a Pacers shooting guard. That's the first thing that we're looking at. I don't even know if I have one, but if I have one, I'll show you. So I don't have one, but let's just say you want to throw a Pacers shooting guard in there. A Pacers power forward is another thing that you want to get and throw in here. So I don't have either of them. But if you have those two things, it's going to make it a lot easier on you guys. So one thing I might encourage you guys to do, I'm guessing you can do it for pretty cheap at the time that I'm recording this video, get a Pacers shooting guard. Chris Duarte, hey, it doesn't matter who. I would get those guys as long as they're able to shoot the ball. And you want to get a power forward that can also shoot the ball as well. So if you can't use Pacers players, guys, it's not the end of the world, right? I wouldn't, unless you have like a really good Pacers player, like unless you have Bojan Bogdanović, I wouldn't go out of my way to do that anymore. Unless you have a really good Pacers shooting guard or a really good Pacers power forward, it might be harder to do. But if you do have like a Bojan Bogdanović, that's going to be a kind of perfect option to get those 4 3-pointers in a single challenge game. As well as, I mean, if you do have it can be a point guard, shooting guard as well. So another thing you might want to do in here, go in here, you look up the Pacers and just see if there's not a shooting guard that you can use that is going to be solid enough to get the job done. Now, I don't know if there is, and that's going to be the hardest part. Justin Holiday is a prime example. So if you have Justin Holiday and Bojan Bogdanović, those two guys is what I was kind of focusing on because they're both really good shooters and going to make that happen. So if you have Justin Holiday, Bojan Bogdanović, use them. If you can't use them, it's just going to take you a little bit longer. But do that. Get that out of the way because then you're going to score with some Pacers players. These don't have to be with any certain team. And then you want to double-double with the Suns player. You can use any Suns, probably center, I think is going to be easy enough to get that done. Like if you have the Tom Chambers, you can use him. Somebody like that. So you should be able to do that in at most, you know, 20, 25 minutes. Obviously, the Celtics win streak, you're looking at probably 35 minutes. And then after that, you're really going to have to play probably 5 or 6 more triple threat offline games to finish the rest, which I do not think is going to be that hard. So let's say you have Justin Holiday. Let's say you have Bojan Bogdanović. Is scary Terry Rozier worth it for you to grind? Now, start off with this. Can play point guard, 6'1", 6'8", wingspan. Hot spots, river, good badges. For our Hall of Famers, 35 on gold, 4 on silver. 92 three ball, 85 driving deck, 93 Z-ball, 86 ball handle, 93 speed acceleration, 87 lateral quickness. Finishing wise, I mean, he's okay, right? He can dunk. Shooting wise, catch and shoot, clutch shooter, mismatch expert, volume shooter. No limitless spot up. I don't like that. Playmaker wise, pretty solid though. Defensively, this is our problem. He is 6'1 with these defensive badges, guys. I'm telling you guys this right now in the nicest way possible that Scary Terry is going to get absolutely sizzled, fried like a piece of bacon on the defensive end of the court. So if you don't care about defense, sure, you can run Scary Terry. Got a good jump shot. I like 107 in general. Base dribble style leaves a lot to be desired. I hate base dribble style, but it is what it is, right? You can work with base dribble style. Problem is, he's an imperfect player in multiple areas. Base dribble style, he can't defend. He's got a 55 interior. He no defensive badges. I mean, the card is far from perfect, guys. Nonetheless, he is a free diamond. Like, he is a free diamond to add to your collection. So am I going to grind him on my either accounts? No, I do not think he's worth the hour grind. But if you are a big, Hornets fan, Celtics fan, maybe Terry Rozier fan, and want to grind the card, hey, you can get him in that hour. But that is going to wrap it up for our video today, guys. I do not think Scary Terry is worth the grind. Drop a like on the video. Subscribe if you are new. And as always, man, I love you guys. Have a blessed day.